Hi guys, this is Saurav. In this video, we will learn how we can create login and sign up form using Firebase in MIT App Inventor. Okay, so here you can see that's the app here. This app we will create in this video. So you will see here first box is username and second box is password. And here you can see it, there's two buttons. First one is login and second one is for sign up. So first we will do sign up here. So I'm going to use here one username, that one is Harry007, and then a password is suppose 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, and now I'm going to click on sign up button. Fine. Now I'm going to change this login credential here, suppose 2 and 3, and make this password 5 and 6. Okay, now I'm going to click on this login button. You will see a wrong username and password. Let's suppose I'm going to change this one username to Harry007 and make this password 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now I'm going to click on this login button. You will see welcome the coding bus. Okay, so that's overall app. We will create sign up form and login form. You can add more fields in sign up. Okay, so let's create this app. So here we go. So first we need to click on start new project. Okay, and that's project name is login and sign up form. That's my app name. Okay, so I'm click on okay and wait some seconds. Now here you can see that's the screen here. Now I'm going to use here two layouts here. First one is vertical arrangement, and make this one width is fill parent, and make this one height should be fill parent, like this. Now we need to change this background color to orange, like this. And now we need here one label, okay, then second label, then one text box, then one password text box, then one login button, and then one more sign up button. Okay, now click on vertical arrangement and make this align horizontal to center, and this one is also center. Fine. Now click on this text box and make this width is 80%. Okay, and height should be 10%. Now click on the password text box and make this one is height width is 80%, and make this height also 10%. Fine. Now click on this one button and make here like login and sign up form. Okay, and make this one at least 20. Fine. And I'm going to change this background color to white, like this. And make this one width also 80%, like this. And make this text align should be center. Okay, click on this text box level 2 and remove this text. Okay, this will display the error. Okay, and make this height at least 10%. Oh no, it's too much, so I'm going to make this one 5%, like this. Now click on button 1 and change this button rename to login btn, and then click on button 2 and change this button name also sign up btn. Click on OK. Now click on button 1 and make this one text should be login. Okay, and make this one width is 80%. Make this font size at least 18 and make it font bold. Change this button background color to something tell or something else that you want, and change this text color to white, like this. Do again for another button, sign up button, sign up. make this width at least 80%, change this background color, just click on login button and copy this background color code. Okay, done. Click on sign up button, background color, custom code, and copy this and paste here, and change this text color to white and make this one is also 80 and make this bold. Fine. And now I'm using one more label to make a difference between both component. I'm going to remove this text and make this hide at least 5%. Okay, so this will look fine right now. Okay, I'm going to use here emulator. You can see that's the design. Okay, so first we need to change the hint text. You will see a hint for text box one. So click on this text box one and make this text to user name. Okay, and click on password text and make this hint password like this. Now you can see username and password. So that's the overall design. Now we need to drag and drop one Firebase here. In the left side you will find your experimental and just drag and drop this Firebase DB. Okay, fine. Now we need to create one account in Firebase. For that just type here firebase.google.com and you will see here firebase.google.com. And you have to sign up, and you can sign up with the Google account, and you will find your go to console option. Just click on it. Wait some seconds, and you will see the add project option. Okay, you will see add project. Just click on this plus sign and type your project name is form login and anything you want. Just click on continue. And then just again click on continue, select account. You can select any account, and if you're not able to find, so you just need to click on create project. You don't need to select this option. Okay, and wait some second, this will create your account, Firebase account. Okay, and you will see here in the MIT App Inventor you can see a Firebase token. This one is default value, but Firebase URL. So this one is default, so we have to change this URL. You will see here this will take some more seconds. Fine, click on continue. Fine. Now click on the database. In the left side you will see here authentication, database, storage, a lot of options, right? So just click on database, and here we need to just change one text field. Okay, wait some seconds. Now we need to click on create database, and you just need to click on next and then done. So you can see that's the right here. Now we need to change this. You will see a cloud file. So you need to change this one, should be real time database like this. Now click on the rules option. Okay, and we need to change this false value to true. For both, make it true. Okay, and make this one is also true. Please don't change anything here, and then click on publish. This one is very easy. Okay, simple. Now go to the data, and you will see here this URL. Just click on this and copy this URL from here, and then go to your MIT App Inventor project and paste this value in the default Firebase URL, right? Nothing, you don't need to do nothing here. Just paste this one URL, this one here in the Firebase URL. Fine. Now let's run some code to store value and retrieve value. Okay, so first we need to save the username and password, because we have to create the account for the user. Then after this we have to check the username and password, if the user is valid or not. So okay, so we will do some code for login and sign up button tomorrow. Okay, because this video is too long right now, it's almost 10 minutes video. So tomorrow we will create the code for login and sign up. Okay, so that's very really really very easy code. You don't need to worry. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me on comment. And if you want to add more functionalities in this app, so just comment on the video. Okay, and please 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 don't forget to subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye. Oh,